Hi, I'm Richard, and today we're going to talk about how to get you into LSE Masters in Finance. This is, in my professional opinion and 10 years of experience as a university consultant, the most challenging Masters to get into in the UK. So I'm deeply proud to personally have a 66% success rate of getting students into this course, which is 11 times the 6% national average. That's less than 1 in 15, as well as a 92% success rate that I have of helping students get into their first and or second choice university. And today, for the first time, I'm going to be sharing a few of my tips, tricks, and secrets to help give you the edge over the competition. Number one, you must show a long track record of academic excellence, but specifically in maths. You need a first class for this course. Yes, they say they'll consider a 2-1, but you need to have something else brilliant because that will be a disadvantage. You need to have smashed your quantitative modules. And so my first tip here is to take those individual scores. If you've scored highly in a calculus or differential equations, put it in your CV. Have the individual grades that you have scored in your CV. Talk to your referee as well. And my second tip is ask your referee to mention the percentile that you were in your class. You are looking to be in the top 5 or 10% of your cohort. So if you're currently still at university, I recommend going on what I call the charm offensive. You want to be sitting at the front of every class first. You want to smash all of the homeworks and problem sets, and you want to be going to their office hours so they can say you were the most attentive, the most involved in that. Interestingly, LSE's finance course, despite being the number one course to get you into banking or similar financial institutions, is a rigorous academic course. They do not accept professional references if you've graduated in the last 5 years. Two academic references, which is rare for a master's program. And this tells us how important it is to show that academic track record. So you need to be thinking very carefully in advance about who you are going to be selecting for your referee, because they are going to be just as important as your personal statement. So make friends with them. And a question I'm commonly asked is, should I ask for a dean of university, someone who looks great but maybe doesn't know me as well? Or should I take my class teacher who's on a PhD and loves me? Pick the one who loves you. If you have a dean that loves you, fantastic. But pick the person who knows you, who can say that you were the top of your cohort. And still, we can go further on mathematics. You should be looking at additional courses. You should be considering the GMAT. Now, it is essential for all non-UK students, and I still consider putting in a strong application with a GMAT. There's also additional courses such as MOOC. So University of Pennsylvania has a quantitative finance for non-finance professionals. You can get a certificate in that. I've had a student get 90% in that, and that shows that you've gone above and beyond. You have chosen to dedicate your time to learning more rigorous mathematics, and LSE will love that. LSE is one of the only top universities that does not interview candidates. So you must have excellence in all of your academia in order to stand a chance of getting into this university. Choose your desk. A lot of people will be applying to this because they want to get into the Goldman Sachs or JP Morgan. Just saying you want to be an investment banker shows almost an immaturity in understanding finance as a real career profession. The top professionals will talk about being a bond or derivatives trader, working in front, middle, back office. They'll talk about the current trends, the bull and the bear market, how the interest rates are affecting the S&P 500. You need to be talking in a certain level of jargon that shows how much experience you have. Speaking of experience, it is nearly essential that you have done at least a spring week and or an internship during your time at university to help you stand out. In fact, many candidates will be applying saying they've already got a job lined up and they've got permission to do the masters. That's how competitive this course is. So another tip I have is think carefully about which year you apply. Whilst this course doesn't require any experience before, most of the people on this course will have 2 to 6 years of financial experience, giving them a huge advantage. There's nothing wrong speaking to a consultant such as ourselves and advising how can you get some experience relative to finance to give your application the chance it deserves. As an example, one student I had a high first class from Russell Group University, over 85% average, and they had a fantastic internship. Before they met me, they still got rejected from LSE Finance, and even I was surprised at just how rigorous it was. Through working with myself as a professional consultant, I was able to advise and help them over a 6 month period to stand out, and they did get in when they applied with me, showing the difference that we can make. Now, other very important tips for any personal statement, there are 5 pillars. Number one, you need a motivational statement. You need to explain why are you applying to MSE Finance? What do you want to achieve? That is very often to get into a specific job. Number two and related is a 5-year career plan. It's not enough just to say the job you want to get into in the specific desk, but where will that progress? How will you end up managing the team? Which bit of finance will you move into? Number three is a deep understanding of the university itself. Unlike the undergraduate course, at master's level, you write an individual application tailored just to LSE Finance. This means you can go much deeper, and I strongly encourage you to stand out by saying which core modules you most look forward to and picking your electives as though it was your first day. Talk also about the societies that you can join, and I strongly recommend you focus here on finance and job-based societies, although it can be fun to mention one society such as dance or an interest to show that you do have some humanity to you when you're not studying. But this really doesn't need to be more than one line. It is also very important to show, of course, work experience. What was the impact that you had with your team? And lastly, talking about that jargon, what is a current interesting topic going on in finance, and dedicating lots of time to discussing this in depth to show you understand what finance is. If you've done a spring week, an internship, or a previous finance job, you're going to have a huge advantage because you'll be able to talk naturally about that compared to someone who may be coming straight out of university. And my final tip is think very strategically about which finance course to apply to. LSE has 4 excellent finance courses. The one with the lowest success rate is the core LSE Finance. Now, there's a very similar course called LSE Finance and Private Equity. It's pretty much the exact same course, except you have to have a dissertation. If you want to work in private equity, absolutely apply to this and talk very specifically about your experience in private equity. Talk about the university research you've done into why that course particular and the additional modules and dissertation, and tell them what you're going to do your dissertation on. That would be a great topic for you to talk about and discuss. But there is no strategic advantage to applying to private equity and finance over finance. And if you don't want to work in private equity, just apply to core finance. But there are 2 other very interesting strategic options here. Number one is risk and finance MSE at LSE. Now, this requires a first class. This requires even more mathematical rigor than the other courses. But if you are a maths genius, if you have that long track record of maths and you like maths, I recommend applying to this one because you can stand out even further above the crowd, giving you that little edge to increase you in those tight margins. And lastly, the most distinct one, MSE Real Estate with Finance. Now, this course is unique because it's the only one that doesn't require the GMAT, making it quite a popular course for those who don't want to put 3 months into GMAT, although a GMAT score will certainly help. Now, that focus on real estate, again, gives you something more to talk about and stand out from other candidates. But if you apply to that course, make sure that you dedicate at least half it to real estate topics. Otherwise, it looks like you're just trying to game the system, and that's how you'll pretty quickly get chucked out of the admissions process. Now, I wish you the best of luck in this competitive course. It is a flagship course of the UK. It is very possibly the number one finance course in the world and almost certainly Europe. Think hard about how and when to apply. And if you'd like to get that extra competitive edge, then please do contact myself and my team to see how we can help you. Now, a course that's particularly interesting is MSE Real Estate Economics and Finance. This course doesn't require the GMAT, which is pretty good if you're looking to avoid 10 weeks of rigorous GMAT prep. It is an economics course as well as finance, but this can give you an advantage. If you have a genuine interest in real estate, if you have work experience in real estate, if you've read up and know about real estate, mention that you like real estate to help yourself stand out, as long as that long track record in maths, which is still very important. We like it when we find more niche courses and we find students who can thrive in that niche, and that's how we help students to stand out. So LSE Masters in Finance acceptance rate is just 6%. It is the joint lowest of any course that we work on in the UK. And that's why I think it's so important to get professional help and expertise to boost your application chances. We have shown through our years of experience that we can get that number up to 66% through good advice. However, if you don't think you're going to get a first class, if you don't quite have the right amount of work experience, I strongly recommend you to consider Imperial and UCL's management courses. Now, both these courses have a finance specialism or pathway, and the second most common career route after management consulting is finance. These are courses with a 2-1, they don't require the GMAT and still have a strong finance specialism, so it can be a really good alternative if you don't quite have that excellent track record of mathematics. LSE Master in Finance is so competitive because it is the best route into a top paid banking job. LSE year after year has the highest earnings boost. That means it gives the highest percentage increase of any course in the UK to your starting and 5-year salary. And for that reason, quite rightly, it has an only 6% success rate of getting in. I hope you can use these tips and tricks to increase that chance for yourself. Is LSE MSE Finance worth it? Yes, I think it is. At over £40,000 a year now, it is a substantial investment, but you can make that back within a couple of years using that earnings premium. If you want to work in the financial sector, this will give you a huge advantage. However, if you're not looking to work in finance, there are thousands of other MSEs that I encourage you to explore. We would be very happy to help you if you contact us to think about which MSE is right for you, as well as when is the right time to do it. Lastly, some of our students hold off on an MSE and then do 4 or 5 years of experience before applying to an MBA, which can give you an even greater earnings premium. So there's so many fantastic education options that can help you to achieve your career goals. If you'd like to work with myself or one of my fantastic team of professional admissions experts to 11 times your chance of getting into this course, contact us using the information on screen now or in the description below.